I don't really remember the first time I heard Don Williams, because for me it feels like he's always been in our house. My dad had, I think, ultimately 13 Don Williams albums, and that was the music I heard more than any other artist in our house.
There's a tear in his voice, there's a cry in it, there's something that draws you to it.
It's such a hopeful voice. It's like everything good, everything figured out, everything kind. It's just like nothing else.
So it goes, while we were busy with the details of our lives.
Oh, I never imagined I'd be doing it for 2 or 3 years. You're absolutely among the most blessed in the world if you can make a living at whatever you love to do.
It's kind of daunting to try to put it in words, but I mean, he really is the one of my mentors.
It's the perfect combination. With Garth at the helm, Garth Fundis at the helm, Don singing a great song, you just can't go wrong.
It was the voice that got me, but it was the groove. It was the groove. It was this, that kind of...
I have drifted across the mountain. I have stumbled down the other side.
Is that whole thing that just like, oh man, it's that. It's so infected the way I play guitar and the way that I write the groove in music. It's really come from all those Don Williams records.
There's a Don Williams groove, like there's a Waylon groove, like there was a Buck Owens groove, like there's a Merle Haggard groove. There was a Ray Price groove. A lot of great artists had as much of a feel of their music, the way, you know, of the grooves and the feel that they had that were as definable as the singer and the song sometimes.
I think what is so appealing about him is what that voice sounds like to people. And it's, you know, it's almost, I mean, the songs are beautiful and the melodies are beautiful and the treatment is beautiful, but it's who you believe he is, which is this incredibly kind, generous, calm, loving human being, and that speaks to everybody. Everybody wants that.
You know, Don's really a great interpreter of emotion, really, without trying to sell you on it. He just lays it out there and states it in such an honest way.
I got some songs in that just came directly to me, but the vast majority of the material that I went through to do the ultimate, you know, picking out came after Garth had already gone through and served as the first filter, you know.
What we do is he finds songs, I find songs, and then we get together and kind of play each other songs that we found. And I think Don used the description one day, I'm trying to remember, it's like it haunts you. That song haunts me. You wake up in the morning, it's one of those songs, you wake up in the morning and it pops in your mind and it doesn't leave. You know?
I always had more faith in other people's writing than I did my own. He got me squared away on that several times, but he'd say, "No, Don, that's really a fine song. We need to address that, you know." But I always found more pleasure, really, in recording other people's songs.
In your heart of hearts, there is a voice. It speaks from truth.
When you're alone with your thoughts and you have to answer to yourself, I think in your heart of hearts, that's the thing you have to answer to yourself in the end. I mean, it's like who you are and how you are and what you were to people.
I don't care if you're a Buddhist or you're whatever, it addresses what your spirituality is and how it's centered in you and is always honest if you listen.
She's with me. If you didn't know, when it's clear for miles or we're on the
darkest road.
One of the songs I got to work on was a song he wrote with his son called She's With Me. And once again, a neat song. And I'll bet, you know, a song like that that he wrote with his son will be one of the ones that's really a feather in his cap and something he'll be proud of.
Tim's my son and a very talented young man. Very good writer, singer, musician. And on occasion, he'll come to me with a song that he's writing that he's hit some kind of a blockade, you know, and I'll try to help him along with it. The vast majority of that song came from his inspiration.
I just come here for the music. I get lost here in the sound.
It's called I Just Come Here for the Music. And it's a love story of you know, someone who's been through heartbreak and he's trying to start something up again. And then in that quest, the lady that he's approaching, you know, has the same story.
I've never been in that situation. I've never been to a dance hall and gone through that kind of a thing, you know. But the emotion of it and the clarity of the characters is just overwhelming to me. And I know that's the reason I wanted to record it is number one, it's very, very well written. The interest is just of what's transpiring is just awesome.
But if you know how strong my love is, and your heart and mine can comprehend.
Well, the opportunity that you have to come up with really new thoughts are so seldom. And I personally have always been very interested in the pyramids and aliens and studying creation and all of that stuff. And for somebody to be able to put all of that together in a song as a new thought, because I haven't heard it before in a song. And at the same time, weave that into what love is and how long love lasts, I thought was brilliant.
Imagine how sweet it'd be to have you here.
I had the pleasure of sitting down with Keith when he first moved to town. He was a huge Don Williams fan. I mean, I figured that out right away.
I have a huge amount of respect for the young lad. I met his family in Australia, and I usually tell him every time I see him, you come from good stock.
When I got the call from Garth Fundis that he was going to do another record with Don, it was like beyond a dream come true. For me to grow up with these records produced by Don and Garth, recorded at Sound Emporium, so to get to spend a day in Sound Emporium with Garth and with Don, it was amazing.
We actually recorded it. We sang both parts on separate mics, but we sang it and recorded it together. It is a performance.
I put the headphones on, I'm singing, Don's over there singing, and it's just, it was like, for me, it was like getting to walk on the moon. It was that surreal.
Even almost nearly 40 years later, at least 30 plus years, I've been buying Don's records and loving his songs. They hold up today. They show up on a radio station and you go, man, that was great then and it's great now. Killer songs, just simple, to the point, and just so refreshing.
Yeah? The choices he makes are just so perfect. How can it be so new and so unique at the same time as being so beautifully familiar.
He doesn't try to sell you. He doesn't try to beat you over the head with his production or flashing lights or pyrotechnics or anything. It's like, here it is. And I think people appreciate that.
That was the neatest part about working on this record was, it's just, it was so peaceful. You know, you hear it and you go, oh, thank you. Somebody's not yelling at me. Somebody's not in my face. It's just, and it was just beautiful. Magnificent.
I don't know who you could compare. Is you couldn't say someone like Don Williams, because there is no one.
Every performance I've ever done is a very humbling experience. Some are just overwhelming. The audience just overwhelms me. It seems that they give me more than I possibly can give them. That's what it usually leaves me with.
I don't know why. I guess I never thought our time could pass us by.